What's up, everybody? This video is dedicated to Maurice Incredible and Everett Harding. I want to do your request on this album right here.
You are now about to witness the strength of street knowledge.
Yes. I know a lot of people have been requesting me to do this album right here, and I'm finally doing it right now. This is N.W.A. Straight Outta Compton.
Yeah, there it go.
Yeah, unfortunately, so I got the album, but they didn't give me the front booklet of the album. They just gave me the CD, but I didn't really care because like, I've been trying to get this album for a while now. And here it is, N.W.A. Straight Outta Compton. You guys, everybody in the world knows who N.W.A. are. No need to... You guys should know the members by heart. Dr. Dre, Ice Cube, Eazy-E, MC Ren, DJ Yella, Arabian Prince. Yeah. And like the group formed in 1986, and Dr. Dre and Yella, they were already working together because they were in that one group, the World Class Wrecking Crew. And World Class Wrecking Crew, they were like this group that was like an electronic dance mixing with hip hop at the time. And so Eazy-E, you know, he was beginning to form his own record label at that time, and he was managed by Jerry Heller. Yes, that Jerry Heller. And he hooked up with Dr. Dre, and you know, he liked what he heard, and so that's when like they were developing N.W.A. at that time. And then Ice Cube, he was brought in later on. Ice Cube, he was already in a group called CIA. And next thing you know, in 1987, they dropped their first single, Panic Zone. And then that later on that same year, they dropped the first compilation, which is N.W.A. and the Posse. Yeah, that album, N.W.A. and the Posse, was like, if you want to be technical, some people do call it like their first album. But at the same time, it was basically like a compilation of, like N.W.A., like affiliates of N.W.A., like Dr. Rock, you know, Doc T, and yeah, so basically it was just that. It was not like anything like, I mean, it was groundbreaking at the time, but it wasn't like anything special. I don't think like when it came out, not a lot of people really checked up on it like that. And so fast forward to 19, that same year, that's when the song Boys in the Hood, that Eazy-E song Boys in the Hood came out. A lot of people really like that. We like that song too. And so that same year, 1988, that's when they recruited MC Ren to the group. And that same year, in 1988, they dropped Straight Outta Compton. That was like a brief synopsis of the whole history. And basically, it was released under Ruthless Under Priority. And the producers include DJ Yella, Dr. Dre, Eazy-E also executive produced it. And the only guest appearance on the album is the DOC, which I'm gonna get into that in a moment. Yeah, man. N.W.A. Straight Outta Compton, you know, that has, this album shocked like the mainstream at the time. And it's like a very influential album, probably in the top five influential gangster rap albums of all time. Everything about it was, it had street narratives, talked about racial profiling, police brutality, like struggles in the ghetto, you know, things like that, you know what I'm saying? Another thing, some things about it, this is actually one of the first albums in general that have a parental advisory label on it, you know? The first hip-hop album to do that was Ice-T's Power album. And Dr. Dre and DJ Yella, they produced, like, I think they produced all the beats. But like most of it was, most of the songs were written by like MC Ren, Ice Cube, and the DOC. See, the DOC, he never really got that much credit. He doesn't get that much credit in general, you know what I'm saying? Because he did a lot for, like, you know, Dr. Dre. He did a lot for, like, Dr. Dre and Death Row. Like, he wrote, like, a lot of, for a lot of people. And check out No One Can Do It Better. His first solo album, No One Can Do It Better, in 1989. You will not regret it. That's, like, one of the best hip-hop albums of that era, you know what I'm saying? Other than that, let me get started with the review. The first song off the album, Straight Outta Compton. Not a lot of these songs have like a lot of, it's like the same subject matter throughout, so yeah. Straight Outta Compton, first song on the album. Great introduction, you know. Everybody like did this thing. In my opinion, Ice Cube, he stole the show off. Like, he has probably the most quotable verse on that entire song. Even though MC Ren and Eazy-E, they did their thing, it was Ice Cube that really got people's attention. Like, Straight Outta Compton, crazy motherfucking named Ice Cube from the gang called Niggas With Attitude. Like, come on, man. With a line like that, everybody should be bopping their heads to that, you know what I'm saying? Track number 2 is my favorite song off the album. Track number 2, Fuck the Police. Yes, this is my favorite song off the album. Self-explanatory. And this was like the song talking about like police brutality and how the police doesn't always look after people. Look after specific people and how, you know, they're always racial profiling, you know, our race. And when this song first came out, it actually got like a lot of bad hate from like a lot of people though. And a lot of people were shocked by the content of the song. At the same time, like, fast forward to like 1992 when the LA riots was happening and Rodney King. That's when people actually really started listening to the song more and they actually really connected with the song. And what else about this? What else about this? And this is also a song that actually the FBI sent out a letter to N.W.A. about the song. This was a song that actually got the FBI's attention. That's another huge point too. And I actually think that Ice-T was influenced by the song when he did Cop Killer, in my opinion. Yeah. This song is very relevant today itself, you know. Track number 3, Gangsta. Another dope song, another underrated song if you ask me. This is talking about, you know, the street lifestyle in Compton, in LA. You know, how you gotta watch out for how you gotta watch out for certain people. Yeah, another really good song right there. Track number 4, If It Ain't Rough. Like an MC Ren solo joint right there. MC Ren, you know, I gotta admit, I never really give Ren a lot of credit. Like, I give, like, Cube. Like, I give Cube a DLC, you know? Because Ren, he can actually really spit, though. I was listening to his first album. What's the name of that album? First album. I forgot the name of the album. I listened to that last year. And it was my first time listening to his soul stuff. And he can really actually spit. And he doesn't really get that much credit. Like a lot of West Coast MCs at that time. And, you know, that song's a prime example of, you know, Ren's delivery, his wordplay, his attitude on the mic, though. Another dope song. Track number 5, Parental Discretion is Advised. Posse Cut, you know, DOC, Dr. Dre, MC Ren, Ice Cube, Eazy-E. Oh, another thing too, I like the way they flipped that Average White Band sample on the If It Ain't Rough. I thought I'd just throw that out. That was on Parental Discretion is Advised. The only Posse Cut on the album. Very, very nice song. That song really, fully identifies with, if you want a clear example of what N.W.A. really stands for, listen to that song, you know. In my opinion, though, I feel like DOC and Ice Cube, and I kind of feel like Ren stole the show on that song. Like, DOC in general, because, like I said, he wrote a lot of N.W.A. stuff, like N.W.A. Death and a lot of Death Row stuff too. And I kind of feel like I wish his career would have gotten very, very big if it wasn't for that car accident that happened back in 1989, 1990. And you know, that really fucked up with his voice. But once I review No One Can Do It Better, probably I'm gonna try to review it by the end of this year. I'm gonna explain more about D.O.C. in general. Track number 6, 8-Ball Remix. Yeah, basically that's just a remix. I believe the original 8-Ball was from the N.W.A. and the Posse album. You know, it was an eye. I'm not really the big fan of that song in general, both the remix and the original version. Track number 7, Something Like That. That's like an MC Ren and Dr. Dre solo track, you know. Pretty good song. One thing that really got me about the song in general was the fact that, like, the chemistry between Ren and Dre. And that's one thing about Dr. Dre, too, you know. A lot of people shit on his rapping. Hell, even I shit on his rapping sometimes. And, you know, but at the same time, though, He still does his thing on the mic. Even if somebody writes some shit for him or somebody doesn't write some shit, he still does his shit. That's all I want to say. What else about it? Yeah. Track number 8, Express Yourself. Yo, man. Yeah. Express yourself, you know. The original version of the song is, you know, some soul song from the early 70s. So they redid his song. That song, believe it or not, it's the only song on the album with no profanity. And no profanity. And basically what I got from the song is, you know, be your own person and express yourself. Don't be afraid. Wait, hold on, not pause, pause. It's basically empowering the youth in a way, and like a message. And it's like one of the few N.W.A. songs with like a message like that. So I kind of felt like it's a pretty dope song. It's a pretty dope song. I know a lot of N.W.A. fans that actually don't even like that song in general because they thought it was too corny. I actually like it. Track number 9, Compton's in the House remix. Yeah, Compton's in the House remix. That's another MC Ren and Dr. Dre track. And it's a pretty aight song. You know, I could have done without that remix. Track number 10, I Ain't the One. That's an Ice Cube solo track. The only Ice Cube solo track on that album. That's one of my favorite songs off the album. You know, basically what I got from this song is he ain't gonna let a female play him or fade him. And, you know, I kind of compare that song to that song You Can't Fade Me off his first album, America's Most Wanted, which I already did a review on. Yeah, I kind of compare that song to that because it has like the same message saying you can't leave, don't let a girl play you or don't let a girl like take advantage of you. Pretty good song. I love the beat though. That beat is really nice. You know, track number 11, Dope Man Remix. That's the remix of Dope Man. Out of all the remixes on this album, this is the one I like the most. Because, first of all, it uses that Ohio Players, like, Funky Worm sample. And I gave out that sample. Anyway, that's a nice-ass sample before it was over-sampled by a lot of West Coast acts. But that's another story for a different day. But, like, when they use that sample first, that was, like, they use a sample first. That's, like, the best way they use a sample. Both N.W.A. and the Above the Law song, 2. And Ice Cube was at his, that's the, his best contribution to the album. He was at his best, like his flow, his vulgarity. Very, very nice song. And track number 12, Quiet on the Set. MC Ren solo track, just like Dope Man was the best Ice Cube song on the album. I kind of feel like Quiet on the Set was Ren's best song on the album. Very, very dope track. Love that song. Love his flow and everything. And track number 13 is Something to Dance To. I don't like that song. I'm sorry. I don't like that song. And it was just like, I kind of felt like Quiet on, they should have ended the album with Quiet on the Set. And I don't know, sometimes it sounded like they were trying to cross over with the mainstream, because you know, the 80s was like the golden era of like dancing music, techno music. So I kind of felt they were trying to cross over. Plus they were trying to like, Dr. Yellow was like really trying to like combine that world class Wrecking Crew flow with their whole album. So that's why I felt like Something to Dance To was out of place. I felt like they should replace that song with probably A Bitch Is a Bitch, in my opinion. Other than that, that's the whole album. On the real though, this is one of the greatest hip hop albums of all time. This album has been widely documented, and this album has very been highly influenced by many people. Everybody from Snoop Dogg to Mac 10, Kendrick Lamar, you know, they all been influenced by this album right here. And you know, this album has been reissued many times. One in 2002, one in 2007, and I believe they recently re-released the album on cassette too. So there you go. And this album, no album was touching this album when it came out in 1988. Like, this is a very vulgar album. And I know a lot of people have said that Niggas for Life is their best album. Yeah, wait till I'm gonna do a review on Niggas for Life probably next week or probably tomorrow sometime. And yeah, that album, I have a lot of shit to say about that album. And I'm going to say which one is the better. So anyway, that's all the time I have. Stay tuned for more reviews. Peace.